Now let us go to the next command, sorting the data. Okay, so sort command, again let us go through the help of the sort command. There are several control arguments again to control the behavior. I will be covering some of those important control arguments. Okay, typically hyphen I is ignore case in many cases, but with sort, I means ignore non-printing. If you want to sort ignore in the case, you have to use hyphen F. Okay, and then you can sort on different aspects. One is if you want to sort numerically instead of strings, we use hyphen N. I will show an example very soon. And you can also define the sort key, okay, which means on which key you have to sort the data. I think here also you can pass the delimiter. Let us see the documentation for the key def. Yeah, key def, we can define the key by saying starting from this character to this character, consider it as a key and sort the data, where F is the field number and C is the character position in the field. Both are in one and the stop position defaults to the line's end. If neither hyphen T nor hyphen B is in effect, characters in a field are counted from the beginning or the preceding white space. So it is similar to fixed length cut command. If your data is fixed length, then you can use hyphen K and you can extract key and you can sort the data based on that key. Okay, let me see if there is any other thing where we can use a delimiter and we can sort the data. If we cannot use this, then probably we can actually use cut and then sort the data. There is nothing like that where, yes, there is a field separator also. Use sep instead of non-blank to blank transition. Let us try this. Okay, so let us log in as dgazraju in this case and go to the data. And again, I will be demonstrating on orders. Okay, now if I run sort by default on this part hyphen 000, it will actually sort the data. And if you look at the sort behavior, you can see it doesn't like it has sorted. Even though it has sorted as a string, typically we feel that it should be sorted by this field so that we get all the orders in ascending order, right? So in this case, in the sorting this as a string, if you want to sort based on numeric value, you can say sort hyphen n and then say part. It might not work. Yeah, it worked actually. So I thought it might not work because the data type of this line itself is not a string. That's why I felt it might not work, but it worked. So what it has done this time, this has actually sorted the data. Assuming whatever is coming in the beginning as numeric value, as numbers itself, and then it sorted it. Okay, so you can see it has sorted in proper ascending order. So hyphen N we'll be using quite often so the to sort the data in numeric fashion. One more common usage is, for example, if I say ls-ltr, okay, there is only one file here. Let me go here and run ls-ltr here. Now, if you want to sort the data based on this field, now I can use the field separator or the length of the field, and then I can use it as key. As it is numeric, I can say hyphen n and I can sort the data in ascending order by them. More than that, there is a command called du, which will give us the disk usage. And if you say star, it will give the usage of each and every directory. And you can see that there is no proper sorting order here. And probably we might want to sort this to see those directories or files which are taking most amount of space in this location. Okay, how can we do that? So there is something called du-s, which will actually summarize. And now you will see a lot fewer fields. And you can see the sizes that are occupied by these directories. And if I want to sort these files in ascending order, I can say du-s star, and then I can say sort hyphen n. It will automatically sort the files in ascending order. So now as the files are sorted in ascending order, we can identify all those directories or files which are taking most amount of space. And if you have to act on them, we can act. Okay. So we use sort along with du also in troubleshooting the most space consuming directories, etc.